Hello, my crafty YouTube friends. Let's have a look. Let's go to this random page here. Grab my paints. I decided I want to do something a bit different. Just recently I seem to be doing quite formulaic pages, like mission inspiration, and, you know, prompt-based things. So I want to play, and I had this idea that I wanted to sort of use these paints to make layers, because they're quite transparent, they should layer over each other quite nicely. Oh dear, it's made a mess already. Oh, here we go. I'll have to wipe that up in a minute. Right, so I'm going to start with the blue. So I'm trying to edit video at the same time, so getting the program loaded. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to start with the blue and a card, and I'm literally just going to, sorry, I know some people don't like that word, literally, overused. Gonna lay down the paint, sort of like this. And I think I might end up making this portrait in the end, maybe. Because I haven't drawn a face in ages. I need to practice. There we go, and I think that is enough of that one, so I'm going to let that, I'm going to dry that off so that we don't get, I don't want the colours to mix, I want them to sit on top of each other and come through each other. Okay, so I'll let that dry and I'll be back. Okay, let's go in with the green, try not to squeeze it this time when we open it. I'm going to use this excess paint on another project. So don't worry about that. I don't waste paint. Here we go. Trying to spread it out quite thin so that it dries quickly. I think that's enough of the green. So again, I'm going to just dry that with the heat tool. Shouldn't take too long. And then I'll go back with the next colour. Here we are, that's dry. Now I'm going to add the yellow. Because I'm going to wet. Great. Really cool. So now I feel like I need to get this dry and then map out where I'm going to put my face. So I will be back when I am ready to do that. Okay, let's just scooch that out of the way for a second. Yeah. So. Get rid of some of these excess marks. I just want to keep working on the background a little bit more now. I want to add some of this into the background. Turn that around a little bit so I don't lean on the paint. And then I want to grab a stencil. I'm just going to have a look through my stencils and see what exactly I want. And I'll be right back. Okay. So I have this stencil that I made myself. It's just a piece of plastic packaging that I've die cut. It didn't go through quite perfectly. So I've had to like hand cut some of the areas. So it's not a perfect stencil, but it's, you know, nice shapes there. So we'll use that, not too much paint. I'm going to do it so it sort of fades off. Sorry, hang on. Okay. A little bit down here. This will probably get covered up by her hair, but it's there. Oh, just in case we don't quite get that far. With the hair, I mean. Some down here. That's quite nice to have that little bit of white space. I don't normally get that in my art, so I'm going to try and leave it if I can. Is that enough? I'm going to leave it at that. And now I think I'm going to grab my gesso. Again, let's move that out of the way. Just so we don't knock it. Yeah, if you noticed, I didn't gesso the page this time. I just went for it. I'm going to gesso her face, or where I want her face, so that I can colour it and paint it in. I'll probably speed through this because, yeah, you don't need to see me just gesso in detail. There we go. So that's gessoed now. That gives me a bit of a base to colour on. I can still see the marks where I have put the features in. So, yeah. I need to worry about that. I don't know if you can see it on the camera, but I can see it. So, it's perfect. So I'm going to let that dry. And then I'll be back when I've took out my colouring pencils and we can start colouring here. Okay, so I have my Derwent Colour Soft pencils, and I believe this is like a face flesh sort of set. So I'm gonna go in with my darkest colour and add the really dark tones. There we go. And then I need to dig out my paint and my glazing medium. Okay, I'll be right back. So I have my, this is Dewcraft Artiste, and it's in flesh, and it is actually my preferred colour for doing skin tones. Pop my glazing medium out here and let's see how well this brush is gonna do. Together. And then we paint. The pencil is going to move with this layer of paint. And we get a nice smooth effect. You can add more glazing medium if you think it's too thick, but I think this is just about right. And the rest of them. This is where it starts to look a little bit more normal and cohesive. One day I would like a nice tutorial and practice on how to draw a man's face, because, you know, pretty ladies are all good, well and good, but, you know, nice to draw a man once in a while. I'm sort of trying to follow the contours of the face as well, so that everything blends in the right direction. I'm very quiet when I'm concentrating. And again, this is just one layer. We will come in and lighten up some areas. If they need it, we can always come back over with the pencil to add shade in. You could even add another medium and go in with some watercolour pens or something like that, which I might experiment with, don't know. I do have some very nice ones that I hardly use. Some skin tone to the lips. I know that's kind of looks like it's obliterated the lips, but we will come over that. Go over that again with some nice lip colour. Layers. Everything you mix me do is layers. Just like ogres. Well, there we go. That is layer number one. Of the paint. So, I'm going to let that dry. Be back. back, as I say, with a lighter layer when that's all nice and dry. I've just noticed that this eye is just a bit bigger than the other one, so I'm going to add just a hint more paint. There we go, that should be almost about right. Okay, so let's pop out some white. And I'm going to mix some of this in. And I'm going to need a bit more glazing medium in there. Because it's quite thick paint, that one. Okay, and then we can pop some glazing medium on the side, so that we can blend nicely. So I'm just going to wipe the brush off a little bit. And we're going to add our, sorry, battery just died, so just pop the spare in. There we go. And then we'll just grab the glazing medium and just fade out the white, the lighter colour. A little. There we go. Brush is shedding a little bit. Let's get rid of that hair. Oh, it's really shedding. Because I'm being kind of scrubby with it to blend everything together. Yeah, just a little hint on this cheek. And on the chin. Just going to grab a little bit of that darker colour in with that. And then I'm going to go around darker again. just to add a bit more. Strength to the colour and cover up some of that pencil just a little bit more, not cover it up but blend it a bit better. That's what I'm trying to say, I think. Soften it slightly. And we will dry that off and then maybe add just one more layer of acrylic there. Okay, I think that's just about drying off now. Going to go in under her chin there. Fix that up a little bit. There we go. And now I'm going to grab some of this white. It does have a tiny bit of peach in it, flesh in it. That's okay. I'm going to add glazing medium to water it down a touch. And then I'm going to go in some white highlights. And then I'm going to grab that lighter again and we'll just blend a touch. Too much there, so let's grab that darker. Blend that out. yeah, she does have a slight haughty expression on her face at the moment. But hopefully that'll be all. Once we get some more details and stuff in there, that'll look good. Okay, so I think that is my last layer of acrylic. I'm going to let that dry. Whilst I'm here, let's grab a little bit more white. Mix it in with that slightly tinted white. And I'm going to go in and do the whites of her eyes. Just where we have the white paint out. I've got too much paint on the brush there. Let's get rid of that. There we go. So yeah, I think I'm going to grab my watercolour pens and play with those next. So I'll be back in a second. And then we need to add just a little hint of eyelashes. Beautiful, and then we need to get that black paint dry so that we can add our little accent of white. I just want to add a little more of the darker pink. To too much water. just need, I don't know what that is on her nose. Is that clean? Yep. There we go, it's gone. So now we just need, where is my white? Here it is. I'm not going to squeeze any out because I just literally need a dot or two. So I'm going to go straight in, see if I have a dry brush. Ooh, that's a pencil. Oh, I'll just use this one. No. It's my watercolor brush, don't do that. This one, and I'm gonna just have to wet it and squeeze it into a little point if I can. Oh, it's not going to go, is it? Just try it with this anyway. Dip it into the white. Gently. Gently. And then dot on the lips. There we go. And now I'm going to work on her hair. Now, I had an idea. Ew, I'm not exactly sure how well it's going to work. But you don't know until you try these. So let me go move this up there and grab my acrylic sheet here. Let's see. I'm going to do a bit of digging, so I'll be right back. Okay, so I have lots of butterfly stencils. Lots and lots. Start with that one, I think. It's my basic butterfly shape. We're going to pop those there. And then I have lots of purples and teals pulled out. We'll start this dioxazine purple because it's the darkest. And just put a few drops of that out. Grab some sponge. I'm just going to start placing some butterflies for her hair. So, quite happy with that flower here. That was really pretty. Very beautiful. And now, I'm actually going to go down the bottom. I'm going to grab out some different colours. And I think I'm going to stencil some flowers. I think I'm going to grab some orange to bring that background colour in. Maybe some yellow as well. A bit yellow in the background. Yeah, let's do that. Let's just swizzle this around. Grab some yellow. Boop. And orange. Ooh. Ooh, too much. Don't worry, I'll use it on something. Here we go. Now, I think I might have to add some die-cut butterflies as well. So, let me just get rid of this paint, which is going all over my scissors and everywhere. And I'll be right back. Okay, so I'm going to just have a quick look through my assortment of butterflies here. See, that is pretty cute. Do I go for that? Does that look good? It's got gel medium. EAU table. Some of the larger gaps there. There we go. And now, just tidy these that. Don't want any more. Is that enough? Yeah, no, it's gonna be too much. Now I think I'm just gonna see if I can find a nice word or quote to go with her. I like to have a word or quote on my page just to give it a bit of meaning. So let me just grab a word or quote sticker and I'll be back. Okay, so I just have Be Bright, Be You. I'm going to pop it here. Yep. And then all I'm going to do is grab, I'm going to put that pen here. This, or today's date. Too many times, the 14th. So I'm going to date it in the corner. And I'm going to sign it because I think I'm going to photograph her and maybe sell some postcards or something, because I am very happy with her. She's got really big eyes, but I think she's really cute. Yeah, I think we're done. Yep, done. I don't really want to do any more. So I hope you enjoyed watching that. And I hope it inspired you to try something a bit different. Yeah, drawing faces. I know it seems a bit scary, but you just gotta practice. She's not perfect, but I think she's pretty, so that's all that matters. I enjoyed doing it. So thank you for watching, and I will see you again soon. Bye bye.